So, even though we are nearly in Season 12 of Apex Legends, I still see a lot of people struggling on how to level up extremely fast and get to the max level, which is 500 within the game.
You serious?
Now look, not everyone has the time that I do, but it's understandable that you guys are still not at level 500 yet with school or with work, or just being a brand new player to the game, and in today's video, I'm going to show you guys just how exactly you can level up extremely fast in Apex Legends. So, I'm going to break down how XP is gained in both BR and arenas for you guys so you can determine which will be most efficient for you. I will of course give my opinion also, but a lot of my opinion may be or may not be dependent on your skill level as a player in Apex Legends, so take that into account when listening to my opinion at the end of the video. Starting off with one of the game modes, we're going to talk about the game mode arenas. So playing with your buddies in arenas or any mode will grant you more XP as well as having the battle pass unlocked on your account. If you don't have anyone to play with, you can always join our Discord and link up with anyone trying to find other players just like you guys, and you can help our community grow as well as on your way to grinding for level 500. For each round you win in arenas, it will grant you 300 XP, as well as an overall win will give you an extra 500 XP added on to your score. And every minute survived within both modes, both BR and arenas, will grant you an extra 180 XP per minute. And the strat here would be, if you can win 2 rounds, then lose 2 rounds on purpose, and then take it to a tiebreaker, and then win both those breaker rounds for maximum XP, you can then just rinse and repeat this process over and over again. Each kill will grant you 15 XP, by the way, and your damage is also included within your total XP at the end of the match, so try to do your best to actually rack up as much damage as you can, because it will add up in XP towards the end of the game. So if you went the distance and the game lasted say 10 minutes and you won 4 rounds to win the game, you would come out with 3500 XP plus the bonus of playing with your friends, and that's not even accounting for damage and kills in that time, which is also kind of a rough estimate depending on how quickly you can get through those rounds. So if you win, most times on average you're looking at around 4000 XP each time you play a match of arenas for anywhere to 10 to 20 minutes of gameplay. Just another thing to note about arenas, you could do that method that I've just explained, or you could simply just constantly farm wins and decimate squad after squad, squad after squad, and just farm the XP off the wins. So you do have two options, whether you want to farm it and prolong the game and get lots of damage and take the round wins and take it to a tiebreaker, or if you just want to constantly get in, get out, get in, get out, farm the XP off winning. So that's really your choice, but hopefully you guys can understand those metrics when it comes to arenas. So moving on to Battle Royale, just like the Arenas mode, you are able to be granted 180 XP for every minute survived in this mode, and this will be your main bread and butter for leveling in Battle Royale. Now I believe Battle Royale has more potential for XP the better you are, as you are granted 100 XP per kill within that match, as well as 500 XP for killing the champ squad in that game and or being the kill leader, as well as the additional XP for being the kill leader within your game. And an added 500 XP every time you decide to actually go on and win the game, and for the next match if you're actually the champion squad before the match even starts. So I think you guys can see just how quickly the XP actually manages to snowball the better you are at the game when playing BR, because if you kill the champion, if you are the champion squad, if you're the kill leader, you get all of this added XP along with 100 XP per kill, and the games last longer from 10 to 20 minutes, so you're looking at like 2000 score just off time survived, as well as kills, damage, being the kill leader and the champ squad, as well as the win. And along with this, even if you're not the best player, the matches do last longer, so you can get more consistent RP, even if you go around, or should I say XP, sorry, even if you just go around looting and just farming damage. Say you want to farm your 4k damage badges, you could have say 4000 XP every time you get 4k damage, and at the same time you're lasting a load amount of time within the matches, so you'll be able to farm score just like that as well. One thing I did also forget to mention is that for each placement that you get similar to ranked, you're granted XP for the longer time survived. So top 13, top 11, top 8, etc, etc, you get what I'm saying. So another reason to, in my opinion, play BR is so that you get these placement scores on top of all of the other things that you can get within the match. So to sum up all of that information, I've gave both metrics for both each mode for you so you can choose accordingly to which one you prefer. But in my opinion, it's best to play Battle Royale for the maximum XP, and here's why. Even if you and your buddies are not the best, you can always run around looting the whole game and maybe farming the bit of damage, making it to top 5, as well as getting the XP bonus for playing with your friends to grant you a lot of score, even if you are not that great in combat. Whereas if you're playing in arenas and you play a good squad, you could get bullied 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, you wouldn't be able to get any round score, damage, or time survive because the game would end that quickly. For players who are skilled, you could play either mode depending on which one you prefer. But hopefully the metrics make it a bit more clearer, and still, in my opinion, even if you are skilled, you should be playing BR for the maximum score. But at the end of the day, just playing the game and taking part in the events and, you know, playing the game a lot, if you genuinely enjoy it and you're not just trying to get the heirloom to enjoy the game, because I know a lot of people will be watching this because they want to level up to get their packs to try to unlock their favorite heirloom, you should be trying to play the game to enjoy it. And if it doesn't enjoy or fulfill that need of joy within a FPS or a shooter that you're deciding to play, then maybe it's not the game for you. But hopefully it is, and this guide helps you on your way to get to level 500 within Apex Legends. And in that case, if it did, go ahead and drop a like on today's video to show your support and help put my video out there in the algorithm. Also, drop a comment to help out this video and let me know what current level you are within Apex Legends, as well as your any of your friends that want to show what level they are in the comments. Thank you for watching today's video. If you want to keep up to date with my content, you can hit that notification bell or join the Discord to try and team up with other players and get notifications when I stream and when I upload to YouTube. We're close to 3,000 subs. It'd be amazing to hit that before the end of February. Thank you very much for watching today's video. I've been Splotchybug, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.